I moved out at 22, but my ex didn't until he was 24, and he had huge anxiety about doing real stuff. It was really putting off to me. Yeah, and look, that's a byproduct of that shit, right? I'm gonna assume it sounds like from what you're typing, that's a woman. I'm gonna assume you're a woman. Based off what she's saying, she's literally proving my point. A lot of y'all dudes have anxiety because you have lived no life. You wait till you 28 years old to hop up off the fucking porch and do something for yourself, and then you be mad anxious because physically you're 28, but mentally you're still fucking 17. Get they heartbroken in middle school and turn into incels. Yeah, that's another thing, right? Motherfuckers be getting they heartbroken at 15 and bro, and like just turning to straight, like, dude, fucking relax. It was a middle school relationship. Chill out, Deku. Like,
and then Jesus fucking Christ. It's about getting in your best shape. On Patreon, we have three free fitness
courses. You just want to show his body off. Free fitness course.
One tool. There's so many other
tools. But you gotta want to do it, though. Like, he's literally telling you. He's like, I got the body. I'm offering you a free fitness course, but are you going to do it? It's up to you to be disciplined. That's why I be saying knowledge is not power. Knowledge is only power when that knowledge is put into practice.
And the second way that you need to have discipline is discipline financially. You need to know where every dollar that you're spending goes to. You need to be saving your money. You don't need to be wasting your money on lavish items.
Ding, 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 ding. This is exactly what I was talking about. And that one video I uploaded, like, it feels like the message got totally, I get it. To some people, like, me moving out with only like $2,000 in my bank account is extreme. I get that, but I made it work. So it's like, if you don't want to do that, fine. Say $5,000, $10,000, whatever. But like, the point is you don't need $30,000 in your bank account to move out. That was the point I'm trying to make. And like, the reason a lot of people don't want to move out, a lot of younger dudes, is because you just want to be comfortable. Somebody said in the comments, well, duh, I want to be comfortable. You need to learn to live below your means. It will humble you and it'll help you save money so you can invest it other. Like, motherfuckers just want to have it all at fucking 22. And that's that Instagram lifestyle. That shit just went over people. I'm like, whatever, bro. When you're 28, there's no way you can give in to me. You're 29 years old, living at home with your mom and dad, and you're happy. And you feel fulfilled as a man. Somebody, it doesn't make me any less of a man. I didn't say anything like that. I'm talking about your personal happiness, your self-esteem. There's no way any man can convince me he's happy living at home with his mom and dad. 26 years old, sneaking chicks in the house in the back. Oh, gotta wait till fucking 8:30 p.m. when my parents are asleep. You're happy with that? Okay. All right, we'll see how that works. And that's why I'm saying, like, that's why I honestly, it's my theory why I think a lot of you dudes have fucking anxiety is because you don't have your own shit. You haven't lived enough life. You're very anxious about a lot of simple, basic life shit, like filing your taxes because your mama's still doing them at 25, bruh. Do it your fucking self, bruh. You know, I used to be really, I used to be really upset that, like, my parents would, like, do shit to me when I was a kid, but now I'm like happy that they did it. Like, I remember when I got my first bank account when I was like 14, 15, I thought my mom was gonna walk into the bank with me, bruh. My mom pulls up to the bank and she says, get out and go open a fucking bank account. I was like nervous as shit. Long story short, I went in there like 15 minutes later, I came out, I had a bank account. I was like, oh, that wasn't so hard. You niggas is weird, bruh. Yo, shout out to Killer Cam with the sub, bro. I ain't give out until 19. Fucking weird. And I truly believe that's why a lot of you dudes have fucking anxiety is because you didn't just jump into the deep end of the pool. Stop putting your toes in the fucking water. Just jump in. Feel the water. It's not that damn bad, bro. It's not that damn bad. That's actually amazing on your mom's part. Very dope. I mean, that's been the story of my life pretty much. Just go fucking do it. And it's like, I be nervous, but then I come out and I realize. And then you do that so many times over and over in various different experiences. And fucking, like, a lot of shit doesn't bother me. And, like, I be so nonchalant about a lot of things when people talk. They, like, people think I'm putting on a front when I say I don't care. Like, I'm like, you see, like, these boxes in the fucking back of my fucking background. Oh, you can't see it. Like, I got boxes, like, to the right of me and then some over there. I've been packing, right? That's how I spent my birthday. I've been packing. I'm about to move. I can't say right now legally where I'm about to move. But in a few weeks, I think it'll be announced. It's all last minute, bro. It's all fucking, I got to break my lease. It's all last minute. Within a few weeks, I have to pick up my life and move it across the fucking country. And I'm like very nonchalant about it. I'm like, whatever, because I've done it before. Like, I've done it before, but like, I'd be very nervous if I never did anything, if I just waited. But if you just wait, if you wait to start living real life at fucking 28 years old, then you're still going to be nervous like you're a 14 year old, because mentally you still, in the back of your head, you always think, oh, my parents got me. I always operate from a standpoint of my parents are not going to be here forever. That's what I always say to people. I'm like, what are you? I'm like, yo, you're like, you know, 25, you know, your parents got a good, maybe depending on how old they are, good 20, 30 years left in them. If they take care of themselves, what you going to do? What you going to do when your parents pass away? I always operate from my parents could die tomorrow. Will I be okay? It's a weird way to think, but like, that's just how I think. It's not. And like, some people are like, oh, you're obsessed with the hustle culture. No, I'm obsessed with having my own shit. I don't want nobody taking care of me. Yo, shout out to Mr. Yabby with the sub. Appreciate it. Bro, ever since you moved out, I didn't ask my parents for shit. Yeah. You know, the crazy part is another byproduct of you moving out, like your parents, because my parents didn't agree with me. My mom didn't care. She was like supportive. But my dad didn't want me to move out. He didn't think I was ready at 19. Fucking yelled at me. But you know, the byproduct of that shit is I kept my head down for like the last 15 years and I worked, took good care of myself. And I'm one of the only people in my family that's not relying on the family for money. I come around when I want to. I do whatever the fuck I want to. I catch flights whenever the fuck I want to. And you get a different level. Your parents will never respect you as long as you're under their house. Even if you're paying rent to support them, they will never respect you the same way. Now I come home and my parents talk to me like we friends. He said, I ain't asked my parents, not parent for nothing since I was 13. I think there you go. Like you get a different level of respect. That's another byproduct. Like, you don't want that. The most important thing as a man is the respect that you get. You don't want that respect, bro. Remember, it's still their house. Ding, 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 ding. And they will throw that shit in your face, bro. You could be paying rent at all times. They could be having a bad day. This is my fucking house. Like, bro. Motherfuckers will start appreciating you more when you come around less. I moved out at 22, but my ex didn't until he was 24, and he had huge anxiety about doing real stuff. It was really putting off to me. Yeah, and look, that's a byproduct of that shit, right? I'm going to assume, it sounds like from what you're typing, that's a woman. I'm going to assume you're a woman. Based on what she's saying, she's literally proving my point. A lot of y'all dudes have anxiety because you have lived no life. You wait till you 28 years old to hop up off the fucking porch and do something for yourself. And then you'd be mad anxious because physically you're 28, but mentally you're still fucking 17. And then it bleeds into other aspects of your life. As you can see, she was dating a dude and she's looking at him like he's not a leader. And women want, contrary to what they say on social media, they want a fucking leader, and if you can't lead, it's not gonna be a good look for you, dude. Like, shit, even if you gotta have roommates, if you and some friends get together and get a spot, that's better than living with your fucking parents. I'm gonna be honest, bro. Like that was another thing too. Like, there's nothing wrong with having roommates. I just don't want no damn roommate. I feel like I'm too old. There's like a certain point where I feel like, and maybe at like 25, you're a little too old to be having roommates. But when you first move out, like 18 to like 24, I don't see nothing wrong with it, bro. Do what you got to do. Baby steps if you have to.
As a man, you got to have
emotions. Oh, yeah. Being anxious is a natural thing, right? Being anxious is a natural thing. Everybody's going to go through it. I still get anxious sometimes. Just shout out to Rico when I'm doing something new. It's just the point I'm trying to make is there's a difference between like a healthy level of like anxiety and like anxiousness and an unhealthy level. I think a lot of dudes nowadays have an unhealthy level, and that comes from a lack of experience, and that shit compounds to where it goes from being anxious to a crippling fear. Cause there's a difference. Like, it's like you're cautious, but you're still going to do it. But a crippling fear, you don't even want to do it. So you just stay in place, basically. And that's what I'm talking about. Don't let it become a crippling fear. You know, it's crazy. Like, y'all will understand this in certain aspects of life, but then you pretend like you don't understand it. And if this doesn't apply, let it fly. But a lot of dudes will understand this concept of why you're anxious for certain situations, but then you act like it doesn't exist with other ones. And I'm talking about real life shit. But let me give you an example some of you Negroes will fucking understand, right? How many of you, the first time you had sex, like, you knew it was about to go down, right? And like, you was kind of anxious, but you could feel it in the air. You're like, oh, this is my first piece of pussy. Oh, yeah, yeah. And you're mad nervous. I don't know what to do. I don't know what kind of moves I'm going to make. Oh, you start making out with a chick. You start blowing her fucking back out, right? And then you're in that pussy. You'd be like, oh, this isn't so bad. I'm doing it. I'm doing it, Mr. Krabs. I'm doing it, right? You instantly get over that shit. It's the same thing, bro. It's the same fucking thing. Fucking, but we talking about paying bills and having a fucking life, bro. You motherfuckers be real. And you be real quick to get over your anxious for some damn pussy, but you won't do it for other aspects of your life. Then after that first piece of pussy that you get, you confident after that. Be like, you know what? I did it once. I think I could do it again. You might still be a little bit, you still might be a little bit anxious the second time, but after the second time, you get a little bit more competent. This is the same. Like, yeah, I got to break this shit down in niggaology for you shit, so you Negroes will fucking understand. Performance anxiety is a real thing, bro. Now you understand, bro. Experience builds confidence, but you will never be confident living in your mama's house. And it was really disturbing to look at that video I uploaded and saw niggas writing whole paragraphs defending why they suck their mama titty, bro. Get off your goddamn mama titty and go do something with your life, bro. And you know another thing? This is how I know niggas is raised by single mothers, bro. Niggas be taking me way too literal, bro. I'm not telling you you have to live your life exactly like me, because that's what a lot of people were... That's where a lot of people were. You said you're speaking from experience. Of course, I was nervous the first time I had sex. Who isn't, bro? I'm not gonna cap on that shit. But like, I saw a lot of people who were saying, like, trying to make it seem like they had to live their life like me. No. All I'm saying to you is do something, bro. You're too comfortable. Well, what's wrong with being comfortable? Everything, little bitch.